What?
Hi friends. Today, I'm going to introduce this multifunctional transistor withstand voltage tester. It can measure the withstand voltage value of a bunch of different components, such as MOS tubes, triodes, diodes, rectifier bridges, and electrolytic capacitors, etc. Next, let me introduce to you what it mainly includes. This one is the test clip wire. Test alligator clips, mainly used for testing SMD components. Short circuit test clip. Instruction manual. Multifunctional transistor withstand voltage tester. Now, let me explain its function buttons in detail. The black one is the negative output, and the red one is the positive output. Here is the display screen, which shows the withstand voltage value of the component being tested. The blue button is used to adjust the voltage. When measuring, make sure this value is at least 1.5 times higher than the component's withstand voltage value. The orange button adjusts the current. It can be set to maximum directly during measurement. This is the indicator light. This one is the test button. Press and hold to start the measurement, and release to end. Here's the charging port, and the other one is the power switch. Next, I will use these components as examples for demonstration. They are an electrolytic capacitor, a small capacitor, a rectifier bridge, a MOS tube, a thyristor, and an SMD diode. First, let's measure this 450 volts large electrolytic capacitor. Here, we will use the test clip wire. Connect the black clip to the negative output, and the red one to the positive output. Remember, it's important to distinguish between the positive and negative terminals of the capacitor. Don't connect them incorrectly. Attach the red clip to the positive pole, and the black clip to the negative pole. Once connected, set the voltage. Since its withstand voltage value is 450 volts, we'll adjust it to around 600 volts, with the current set to maximum. Turn on the power switch, and press the test button to start measuring. The capacitor will have a charging process, and the voltage will rise quickly until the rising speed slows down or stops, which is its withstand voltage value. Attention, not to test components for more than 1 minute, or they may get damaged. If the voltage does not rise in 5 seconds, the component may be damaged, and it is recommended to stop the test. Okay, this is its withstand voltage value, which is around 550 volts. When removing the clips, take off the positive one first, then the negative one. After that, discharge the capacitor. Next, let's measure the 25 volts small capacitor. Likewise, connect the red clip to the positive pole, and the black one to the negative. Adjust the voltage to be 1.5 times greater than the component's withstand voltage value. The current can still be set to maximum. No further adjustment is needed. Start the test. Capacitors will have a charging process. We can see that its withstand voltage value is around 46 volts. Let's continue to measure this rectifier bridge, which is withstand voltage value for about 1000 volts. Connect the positive and negative poles. Then adjust the voltage to be greater than 1.5 times its withstand voltage value. Start the test. It shows a withstand voltage value of around 1200 volts. Let's switch to the MOS tube. If we don't know its parameters, what should we do? To measure a MOS tube, we need to use the shorting test clip. Short the G and S poles like this. Then connect the red clip to the D pole of the MOS tube, and the black clip to either the G or S pole. Let's turn up the voltage a bit. Its withstand voltage value is around 31 volts. This is a varistor, which doesn't require distinguishing between positive and negative poles. As mentioned earlier, if the parameters are unknown, just set the voltage a bit higher. It shows about 500 volts. Lastly, let's check out this small SMD diode. With this line as the boundary, the part with a larger area is the positive pole, and the other part is the negative pole. We need to replace the test alligator clips. The red cable is inserted into the positive output, and the black one is inserted into the negative output. The red side is its positive pole, and the black side is the negative pole. Clamp it as I demonstrated. Since we don't know its parameters, just set the voltage higher. It shows the withstand voltage value of around 120 volts. Alright, that's how to use this tester. Thanks for watching.